Hi everyone, Jax here again, and I have an unusual video. I'm going to be doing an unboxing video. I don't usually like unboxing videos, but I just got this and I want to unbox it, and so we might as well do it. This is, I'm not even going to be able to get on camera, this is the largest sword box I have received. So let's just pull it out and see what it looks like. Some of you have probably seen this type of packaging before, so maybe you can guess what it is. It had been delayed for a couple of days, had to chase it down, got rerouted, and eventually was able to find it and have it directed to where it was supposed to go. So I've been waiting for it for quite a while. Ha, got the right end. Unfortunately, it's got some styrofoam in there, so it's going to make a little bit of a mess as it's coming out. Oh, wow. This has a bag, too. Try and get this all on camera. Alright, this makes great film. I was trying to do it in one piece, like, consider the box, but... It's so snug, I don't know how to be able to do that. Yeah, there's a swell in there, so I'm probably just gonna have to take down one of the walls here on this one. It's a shame, but it's a pretty box. And if you are constantly flying and filling swords, then you need to be constantly on the transport, so... Very carefully, down one inch. Especially on the defensive phones, guys. Making sure that I got prep rate on my case today. I've never done this kind of tea before. I've never done things that I have not wanted to cover before. But, never done this tea, fortunately. Aha, there it goes. It's been released. Oh, yeah. Pardon the coughing. We're just recovering from a little bit of a cold. And we'll get some of this off. And this will be the largest sword bag I've ever seen as well. Has anyone figured out what it is yet? For those of you playing along at home. So I have no shortage of swords to review that you guys can see behind me. But this is another in the line of LK Chen swords. This specific one is from the Ming Dynasty. Oh, double wrapped. How's this wrap done? And it is okay. You're getting to see the entire process to see how it comes fresh out of the box. So we have one outer wrap. I'm trying to do this in a way that I'm not going to cut myself open. There we go. Shoop. So you have one sword bag. They gave me two whole sword bags. Not sure if that was intentional or not, because it looks like they're big enough that they covered the bag's fine. So somehow I ended up with two sword bags. And here is the great reveal. Whew! Oh man. So this is the LK Chen Imperial Guard Chengdao, which is one of the longest swords he produces, if not the longest. I'm not going to take all the wrapping off of the grip for right now. Really do like how the Hushou Pan, the guard, looks and has come out. The scabbard is in beautiful condition, so maybe the double wrap was done just as an extra means of protection for it. And everyone wants to see the blade, so we'll do that. It looks like there was a bag on the blade. Let me see if I can capture that, so it doesn't get stuck in my scabbard. Yeah. So, minor difficulties in that there was a bag protecting the blade that was inside the scabbard. So that required a lot of nuance to make sure that when I drew the blade out of the scabbard, the condom did not stay inside of the scabbard. But it'll come off. It's got a lot of grease on it to keep the blade well protected. And ooh, what a beast. This is a big sword. I'm not gonna be able to see it all here. It's gonna take a lot of practice in order to figure out. This is way larger than the usual collection of swords I do. Here, I'll just very briefly hold it up there for a sense of scale. It doesn't even fit on my rack right now. And I'm going to need an entire new workout regimen if I'm going to be able to work with this sword. Anyway, very first impressions out the box. Really like everything. Needs a little bit of cleaning just because it's got some grease on it, but it came through in beautiful condition without any problems, and very impressed at the first initial reactions on the Elkechen Imperial Guard Changdao. Bonus feature! It turns out there was something else in the package. I almost forgot. This will have been the first non-sword item that I'll have picked up in a long, long time. But it was too good to pass up. Yeah. I forget the exact model name, but this is a replica of a Han era spearhead. It was just a couple of bucks, so I think it was like 20 bucks. I've got to say, that is very nice. I'll have to actually put it on a shaft sometime to see it. But I'm always impressed at what you can get for reasonably inexpensive price when it comes to spearheads. Just have to have a place to store spears. I don't specialize in spears, but I can certainly appreciate them when I have the opportunity to look at them. Just first impressions, it has the same type of octahedral shape or eight-sided shape that you see on some of the early Han period weapons that you found in the Chu state. So things like the magnificent Chu Gen have the same idea, where you have almost like a fullered, double fullered central section before going out to the, if you want to call it the secondary bevel. But yeah, very, very interesting little spearhead. Okay, that's it.